We were in and out in 36 hours.
Yeah, you were exhausted. So there you were, holding Alex and fighting like hell to stay awake for me. And you fell asleep. Now, I may have been young, but I was smart enough to know that there are very few certain things in this world. And seeing the two of you like that, I said, damn it, one thing is sure. That man will always be there for his boy. You let me down, Hollis. But more importantly, you let Alex down too.
Should have known this was coming.
I couldn't talk about it last night. I had to make sure you had changed first.
Alex is an adult. He made choices, choices that left no room for me. And I tried to help many times, but he just cut me out of his life.
Okay, well, now's your chance to fight your way back in. I mean, the last few years have been very hard on Alex. But he's clean now. And I worry every damn day that that's gonna change. And I'm tired of worrying alone.
What do you expect me to do?
He goes to a treatment program. It's outpatient, but he's really sticking with it. And they have these family groups that I'm going to, and I want you to show up for him.
He doesn't want me there.
But he needs you there. Look, I'm not even saying you have to jump on a plane tonight. You don't even have to give me an answer now. Just promise me that you will think about it.
Fine.
Good. I know, I didn't cook all day for you to have this meal cold.
What are we having?
Crab legs. Do you want some more wine?
No. No, I think I'll switch to scotch. I think I'll make it a double.
The warmest place in town.